Antimicrobial agents are a class of medications that work to eliminate potentially harmful organisms such as bacteria and fungi. As a respiratory therapist, you will be required to have an understanding of this type of medication, which is why we created this quick video to help. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. What are antimicrobial agents? As previously mentioned, this is a type of medication that kills harmful microorganisms and/or stops them from growing or spreading in the lungs. Antimicrobial drugs are typically classified according to the microorganisms that they act upon. For example, antibiotics are a type of antimicrobial agent that fight against bacteria. Antifungals are used to fight and eliminate fungi. And antipneumocystis agents are used for treating patients who are diagnosed with AIDS. Antibiotics are the most common type within this class of medication. And as I mentioned, they are used to fight different types of bacteria. Whenever a patient is showing signs and symptoms of a bacterial infection, as a medical care provider, this is when you would know that an antibiotic medication may be indicated. Some common signs and symptoms to look for include fever, chills, diaphoresis, green or yellow sputum, and an increased white blood cell count. In order to determine which antibiotic should be administered, a culture and sensitivity or Gram stain test can be used to identify whichever bacterial organism is present. This would allow you to choose the most appropriate antibiotic agent. As a respiratory therapist, there are some inhaled antimicrobial agents that you should be familiar with. Here are some tidbits to remember. Penicillin is an antibiotic used to treat gram-positive bacteria. Gentamicin is used to treat gram-negative bacteria. Pentamidine or Nebupent is administered to treat pneumonia caused by the Pneumocystis carinii fungus. Aerosolized tobramycin or Toby is often administered to treat patients with cystic fibrosis. Aztreonam or K-stone is commonly used to treat Pseudomonas in patients with cystic fibrosis as well. Ribavirin or Virazole is administered to treat RSV in children. And zanamivir, also known as Relenza, is an approved medication used to treat the flu. Again, we created this video just to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.